have lost thee. Really, a little bit of brief wandering, and it started out two hearts cold, kids with nothing. Suppose that you think that it's something. Hi, I'm Noreena Palo, and today is December the 18th, 2013, and it's the first day of recording EP number one of 12 I'll be making in 2014. And we're in Rack Studios in St John's Wood, London. And I'm going to talk to you a bit about the process of why I'm doing this, how I'm doing this. I must be mad. And I can't wait to see you in a year when hopefully I've done it and it's all over. The reason I decided to do an EP every month of the year for 2014 is I recently made a Christmas EP, and we did it in one day, and we cut it live in Rack Studios, and I had an amazing time. And during one of my more excited moments on the day, I announced to the room, "I'm going to make an album a month for 2014," and they were like, "Right, you are, an album a month." And I was like, "Yeah, I'm really going to do it." And then I thought about it a bit more, and I thought, okay, an album's a bit of a big ask, but I could do an EP. It's possible. So I sort of sat with the idea for a few weeks, asked a few friends their opinion, thought about it logistically, and also I thought, okay, I'm going to do it. I want to challenge myself as a songwriter and just as a performer, and take a lot of the experience I've got as a live performer and having to be in the moment and make it happen and transfer that to the studio. And also to sort of go on a musical journey. I've been working on an album that I feel isn't quite finished, but is quite a departure from my previous albums. And I'd like to sort of use this process to get me from here to the album that I'm currently making. It is a different process from making an album in the traditional sense, in that I don't have the luxury of endless time, of infinity, and I don't have the luxury of procrastination, so I have to book a recording day and be ready so that when I step in the studio, the songs are written, the arrangements are done, it's charted, the musicians pretty much know what they're going to do, and just go for it. Because I find that when you make albums, they become these things that go on forever, in my experience. You know, I'm quite a way into my career, and I only actually have four albums to my name, but I've been doing this for over a decade, and I'm a big faffer.
Yeah.
And I've ditched more albums than I've actually put out, just because, I'd like to say it's because I'm a perfectionist, but that would be totally untrue. It would just be because I love things, and then I get bored of them, and then I never see the light of day. And so this is really about being focused and really disciplined, and it's something that I've been sorely lacking. Is that the right kind of tempo?
One, two, three.
It started in the fall with familiar. You do feel more pressure. It's just time pressure, though, when you're doing it in this way. But actually, what you're having to do is make decisions. And modern recording techniques have really reduced the decision-making process, because the hard drive recording allows you to do a gazillion takes, in the way that when you used to record on analog, and I'm so old now, I can actually remember recording my first album on tape. So give me a sign, this is my. Although I'm not using analog equipment anymore, I'm having to make decisions much more quickly, and I don't have the luxury of doing 10 takes of one song. I'm going to have to make the best choice out of 3 or 4 takes. It's a little like that. But again, that's not always a bad thing, because sometimes when you sit with things for too long, you lose the wood for the trees, and you can't see the wood for the trees, that's the saying, isn't it? Because you have all these multiple options, you can't tell anymore. So I think it might be a really good exercise in being instinctive and decisive. And I also think that part of the creative process is spontaneity, and sometimes making albums, we kill spontaneity. We go through about 4 or 5 versions of the same song, and nearly every time you do that, you always return to the demo and go, that had something. Why has it never had something in subsequent recordings? So I want to get that spontaneity and that freshness that you get when you've just written a song and you've just recorded it, but finesse it slightly. Turn it up louder, turn it up louder. I'm still in December 2013 at the moment, but I'm planning ahead because obviously I have to. So right now, today I'm making the January one. And I think you can't help but be influenced by your environment in terms of the weather, the seasonal stuff that's going on, that angst at the beginning of a year, thinking about all the goals you didn't make this year and who the hell makes resolutions anyway? All that kind of stuff. So that will probably, and I know it's influenced the writing process on the songs on this EP. I'm not thinking of doing like themed, like here's the Easter Bunny EP and here's the Thanksgiving EP. That just becomes cheesy. But I think what I might try and do is make a couple of the EPs more genre based. So I'm already sort of formulating the idea. I would quite like to make a power pop EP. My second album had moments of power pop that I haven't really revisited, but I'm a big sucker for things like Jellyfish and Steely Dan and Rush and Boston, and I love all that stuff, and I've never really done that for a long time, and I kind of want to make an EP like that where it is very pure in that sense. I'm singing in the dark, turn it up louder, turn it up louder, turn it up louder. Is anybody there? Turn it up louder. I think because it's going to be a process over a whole year, and because not everybody I work with is going to all be available at the same time, I'm going to have to work with a different bunch of musicians from EP to EP. But actually, I think that's really good, because I'm a bit of a one for getting stuck in the same pocket with musicians, and then I get very comfy and I don't always necessarily change what I'm doing. And I think the whole part of this process, for every musician, I think it's a really good thing to change up who you work with, because you're asking people to bring their individuality to it. So I'm actually looking forward to that, of not having the same group of musicians every single time. And also, if I want to do something that's really power pop, I might use a different guitar player from the person I'm going to use if I do something that's more jazz or R&B based. So yeah, it's going to be really good. I'm really looking forward to that. And I get to feel incredible, but it's all inside my head, you see. And I get to feel redemption when there ain't nobody else at home, but I'm only amazing on my own. Hallelujah. Could it just give me your brain? It's quite mad, because this is the first EP, but if I don't envision myself a year from now finishing it, I haven't got an end point. So I guess what I hope is, I'd like to have roughly 60 songs that I'm really proud of. I'd love to see that the songwriting has been of a consistent level. That's the main aim for me. And the reality is, I have to get to the end of it. Of those 60 songs, I reckon they'll have come from about 100 songs, because I really believe that, because I want the songwriting standard to be really high, I'm going to have to write a lot more than I actually use. So I'd love to have this body of work, and what I plan to do is maybe put out an album of the best song from each EP according to fans and just input. So I have nothing to do with it. I just poll everybody who's been listening to the EPs over the year and then put out a definitive album, possibly on vinyl. That might be fun, you know. I'll be doing download and CD physicals of each EP, but not vinyl for every EP. That's just, I wouldn't get crazy. But it might be fun to do a vinyl at the end of the year.
And all you ever wish for, a little bit of respite. Don't you ever long for a hand to hold tonight? Oh, don't you ever wish for a little bit of respite?
I do think the way we're consuming music has changed, but I wouldn't say it's like had a premeditated influence on why I'm doing this. It's just, I think it's a natural reaction to the way media is now. It's fast, and albums don't hang around for years on end. I mean, the odd one does, like Adele's 21 has, because that's a monster album, but a lot of things are... I think also people have access to more music than they've ever had before, and I'm a big Spotify fan, so I go on Spotify, and if I love an artist, I suddenly discover there's all this stuff, and I kind of skip and I want to hear more, and I think there is an appetite for it. I think especially for fans, when you like something, you just want to hear as much of that artist as you can. So I appreciate that the casual Lorena Palo listener may be like, oh my God, love, I can't deal with all this music, I just have one or two tracks. I'm happy for anyone to listen to my music, you know, from once in their life to every day. But I do feel that I'd like to do something for my fans who, at this point in my career, it's very much fan-supported, and my fans have kind of given me my career. And so it's a way of kind of giving them as much stuff as they want. And it'll be interesting to hear their feedback during the process as well, you know. I'm really open to that, so we'll see how it goes.
Should we get everybody in? Come on then, kids.